Well, hey, my name is Brad Mock. I'm the high school director at Christ Community Church, and we just wanted to welcome you back to the State of the City Summer Dive Series, and just wanted to dive into some next-gen thoughts that we have around this book that's been shaping our ministry and hopefully some of what you're doing as you're trying to make an impact in your city. I was thinking about specifically on page 66, where it talks about how 53% of the Omaha population says that they feel depressed at least once or twice a month. Man, but that number jumps up to 65% among millennials and 74% among Gen Z. And so probably more than ever in my ministry, one of the big changes that we're making is just focusing on mental health a lot more. It's something that we're talking about as a topic in our large group programming. We have quite a few volunteers who lead our students, and we're doing more equipping than ever of those volunteers so that they feel comfortable when a student comes to them with something going on in their world. What would they say? Of course, those volunteers aren't going to ever be like a licensed counselor or anything like that, but how can they just help a student a little bit along the way and just make them better equipped for those conversations that maybe in the past maybe could come, but now they're for sure going to come their way as a volunteer leader. You know, I had one of my students just say to me, "Hey, Brad, man, I love that we're talking about the Bible all the time at church, but when are we going to talk about mental health stuff that's really going to make a difference in my life?" And so we've just been trying to address it more and more and help students with those things and see how God impacts those different parts of their life. Specifically, I want to talk about One. And if you haven't heard about One, it's a gathering every August of thousands of high school and middle school students in our city. And we worship Jesus and we celebrate unity. But then our goal is to really send those students out into their community to make a difference for what God is doing in our lives. And this book has even shaped how we're doing that event, specifically the four different initiatives that we have in our city. And one of those is Flourishing Churches and Leaders. And that team that has planned One in the past has been a pretty small team, but we've changed that team to be like a dozen people on the core team. And even people who aren't on the core team are chipping in more and more this year and hopefully years forward. And we just want to develop leaders and give opportunity for different people to speak into this thing and shape it. And I think the other initiative that we've really embraced with how we do One is the one about flourishing neighborhoods. And the idea that we're sending our students out back to the places they come from to go be evangelistic and make a difference in their schools and the places that God has them, their workplaces, all that kind of stuff. And we have students coming from all around Omaha, over into Council Bluffs. And so as God brings these students to this event and we send them back out, man, we're excited for what that's going to do to cause their neighborhoods to flourish even more so. Page 82 in the book, and page 82 is about different trauma that people in our city are experiencing. And so we've actually got an upcoming topic this year in our youth group where we're going to be talking about some of these traumas that people experience, like death of a loved one, addiction, job loss, stuff like that. And we're going to be talking about, okay, how does God impact your life in those areas? And what does God have to do with some of those things? But we're not stopping there. We're actually taking it to the next level. And we're also equipping our students. Okay, how do you care for one of your friends who might be experiencing this trauma in your life? Man, I know for middle school and high school students, a friend tells you like, "Man, I'm going through this trauma. You don't know what to say." But man, when you can just have a few empathetic and caring words, that can be a huge difference that you can make to really open the door to share the gospel and just care for somebody when they have a need. So that's one of the things that we're really adjusting moving forward based on that. And one last thing I just want to say through all this is the importance of just continuing to focus on Jesus. I've talked a lot about mental health, and I think it's super important to address. There's pages like page 60 that talk about how one of the biggest impacts in people's lives is if they're diving deep into faith and diving into relationship with Jesus. And so I just want to encourage us, especially as church leaders and church people who are watching this, man, continue to hold Jesus at the center of this thing. That doesn't diminish some of the practical things that we're doing in our city that are meeting physical needs. But I just want to encourage us to continue to meet those spiritual needs as well. And putting that together like Jesus did in his ministry, the physical and the spiritual, excited to see what God does in our city as we all work together on this thing.